Alright, and back to XCOM 2. My series is always Plan B, and this is TJYYC. And I've just added a few of the subscribers into and followers into the pool. So we have I'm a Turtle, the first Twitch subscriber, and he is the Grenader, and he's rocking some green and some green glasses. We've added a couple of just cosmetic mods, and I think Overwatch All, so I have a few more character customizations. I have some friends in real life that wanted to be part of the squad, so we have Bounce Aquachi running in the blue. We got some Ballistics headgear. It's gorgeous. We have a potato salad here, rocking the swords and the half hair. We have Ozamemzis, rocking the pink, all the heart influenced weaponry as well there. So we're going to continue on with our missions here. So we got some resource casts, we got some black market, everything's asking for our presence. Okay, where is the where is our machine right now? Sitting on the resource cache for supplies, but on the other hand, I want to get this this mission going over here. I know when I complete it, I'm going to have a mission, though. So I should check my armory and make sure I take a look at my soldiers, see who's injured, who's up, who's available. We got four available, and we'd like a few more than four available, so I think it'd be okay to take a couple seconds of breathing time and wait for a couple more soldiers to come back online. On the other hand, getting India under our control and having more money would also be a very good thing. I think we're going to continue making contact with India. Indian regional zone. All right, and we're going to click the button. Alright, we've got the alien debris cleared. Very nice. And it can now be anything. However, and I think what we were planning on building in there initially was... what was it here? We wanted the doodads that could send robots to assistant... adjacent labs. Proving ground. We definitely need to build an proving ground. Because that's now a quest option. That's it. The workshop. Engineers can be staffed in workshops creating unique gremlin drones which can be sent to staff any adjacent room or facility. So that means it could go to here, to here, to here, or to here. So I think that building a workshop was high on that priority list. It's at 125 supplies, but I think what was even higher was going to guerrilla tactics, new combat tactics, and getting vultures, so we get a few more weapon upgrades, and that would be really useful. I really like having lightning strike, being able to move faster too, but we don't have enough money for everything. Money's tight right now, but I think vulture is really good. We need those extra weapon mods right now to beef up our troops, I think. So we'll do that. We'll continue on with that. I know I don't have an engineer assigned to any place right now.
Commander, I appreciate you recruiting new staff for the engineering team, but as it stands, we have people still waiting for an assignment. We can have them working on construction, excavation, or staffing a facility.
Let's just... We can have her excavate. That's only 5 days, so that's okay. And it'll get free us up some more supplies, too. So we'll carry on trying to make contact with India. Alright. This is fantastic. Hey, hey, we're Xcom. I imagine that's what the guy's saying there.
Objective added.
The mysterious Advent Black Site must be investigated by an Xcom strike team, and any relevant artifacts must be recovered for study. So I can complete the Black Site mission. Advent Black Site mission, yes. And we have to use a Skulljack on an Advent officer in combat to gain access to the alien communication network. Now, I know I've written in my descriptions of my YouTube videos that I have not researched anything about this game, but I do know two things about this game. One is that something bad happens to whoever soldier does the Skulljack, and that's unfortunate that I know that. It would have been a great surprise to me, but don't expect me to send my best, most well-trained, most loved soldier to do this. The second thing is that I know that doing a melee attack against a Muton doesn't end well. Other than that, I don't know anything, but those things I unfortunately know.
The local resistance, and we can move on the Advent Black Site on your order. We should make sure our troops are fully equipped and ready for a tough mission. I'm guessing security will be tight at the facility. Commander, I've updated our current objectives based on the most recent findings.
New regional contacts located.
All right. The word of the resistance is spreading, Commander. Making contact with the people in New India, the local resistance in East Africa is now available for contact. And West Asia. We can contact them too. And Indonesia. Alright. I think being able to offload some stuff on the black market might be good. If this mission is as hard as it says it is, I might want to have a little bit more experience before investigating that black site. So we're going to maybe collect some supplies and do a few more things before we do that. How long will it take to make contact with New Arctic? Just 3 to 5 days. So we're going to go and do that.
All of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Duly noted. Okay, so I'll make contact with
New Arctic. Just got word that the resistance hit an Advent supply line. We have an opportunity to salvage some high-value materials, assuming we can clear out the alien forces guarding the site first.
Oh, well, we will go do that. Alright, so Operation Storm Witch. Raid the Advent troop transport. Advent is moving valuable alien technology across East Asia. If we strike quickly, we can cover the alien tech for our own purposes.
Setting course for Sector 14, East Asia.
We were just about to contact the New Arctic and we've become busy again. Alright, let's see, who do we got here? We also have the ability Show Me the Skills, so it actually shows my skills for my troops down at the bottom here, too. This said, we're running a squad of all Jedis, and I don't think we need a squad of all Jedis. So... we're going to pare down this squad and get a few more rookies in, a few more experience. We actually have no rookies left. Everyone is trained up. So can I duck out right now and hire people? In the original XCOM, it took a few days to do this. But looks lots of them looks interesting here. Beard, we've got mohawks.
I've warned the crew to stay away from the Advent meat rations. We still don't know what they're putting in that stuff.
Ugh. She looks pretty badass. I think we'll bring in Safara Hanega. I think I'm hurting your name. Should we recruit maybe another soldier too? We may get more recruits. So I think we'll just head right back into the mission here. Right. And I'm going to say that this maybe is a wide open area. Well, we got Sergeant Kelly in now. I think a small amount of time passed and she became available. That's good. We don't need two people with grenade launchers. So our sergeant is going to be removed out. And our brand new squaddy, Aza Memzis, is going to be fighting along on the field. And then we're going to add our rookie in. Because I think it's important that we train up a bit bigger squad, especially if we get another squad size update. And then we're going to go and edit some loadouts. So, as far as Kelly's concerned, I think we're going to still give her the nanosteel vest so she can go and take a licking and keep on ticking. I am perfectly fine with the sniper still having the medkit. The rookie having a frag grenade, I think that's okay. Certainly on our grenade launcher. We're going to change her loadout. So it's not just a frag grenade, she's also going to get a smoke grenade. But I think we need to make items available. Alright, we'll make out all the things. All the things are available now. Alright. Then we can now we can change it for smoke grenades and flashbang grenades. I think we'll have the long range flashbang grenade on her. And we'll leave the rookie with the grenade for the possible kills. And we'll let... Oops. Who did I just deselect? I want someone with the gremlin so we can do the remote hacking if required. And she'll carry around the smoke grenade. And the Kevlar armor is all we have. She looks kind of... Miss Corporate Gallagher looks kind of boring. We might end up switching her out with a potential YouTube or Twitch follower. But she needs something cool for this mission to give her a character shield. I think that's very important. So we're going to give her better hair, I think. And a goofy hat. I don't... Not that good. No. Those seem, like, slightly offensive. The tactical cooking pot. Why did I download this pack? I'm not sure. There must be something in here. Alright, construction helmet. She's an engineer. Engineers are a credit to team. And we'll dress her in red because she's an engineer. And her weapon needs a pattern if she's an engineer, like zebra print. Yes. The village people are assembled. You're just dressed in tan. This kind of bothers me, Squatty Peterson. You're the only person that wears a helmet, but that's okay. You're a sniper with a helmet? Nah. No, that won't do. That won't do. See, you need something cooler on your head, I think. I might have to get, like, the Dragon Ball Z style, hope that Dragon Ball Z style over 5,000 little visor is available. Night vision goggles, even in the daytime, is I think, appropriate for you. And... yeah, something like that. And your armor color... I'll make you look a little bit more like that. I think that's cool. I'm feeling better about this squad now, because they look cool. You just get dressed in tan because you're a rookie. You only get to be cool when you earn your stripes. I'm sorry about that.
Ranger deployed. Menace ready to deploy.
Let's begin the mission.
Picked up an alien transmission. They're trying to move an advent troop transport the resistance disabled during a recent skirmish. There's an opportunity here for us to pull some of their technology off the transport, but we'll need to secure the area and eliminate any remaining hostiles to make that happen.
All right, let's get some loot. Maybe I'll get supplies or something. Really, it's the construction hat that's awesome.
1-5. The Advent troop transport is nearby. Engage and eliminate all hostile forces.
Yes, sir. Now, I don't think the sniper has anything besides a squad sight. At any rate, we're going to,
heading there now.
Start running out inside the graveyard here. We haven't seen anyone yet.
I'm on the move.
Without the introduction of human DNA,
ooh,
these creatures, once operating under the guise of thin men, now show their true form. A purely reptilian species.
Whoa.
The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
Well, what about the faceless? They're pretty scary. Okay, I don't see any high ground for my sniper. So, he's just gonna take whatever's, like, I suppose convenient.
Let's do this.
I don't know how close they're going to get to me. This mission doesn't appear to be timed, though.
Roger that.
I'm gonna have some of these people, maybe. That apparently would get me seen standing there. I'm gonna have her stand behind this statue here. And the rookie can come around the side and support where the sniper's position is. And everyone else can overwatch.
Overwatch.
Hopefully they don't come too close. Whoa! All right, Okay, so within one square of being identified, that was way too close for comfort there. Alright, so Sniper Corps, I believe, has a good beat on both of them. Right, but cannot be herself necessarily the aggressor on the Overwatch, because she doesn't have Overwatch sniping.
Okay.
So she's going to be the initiator. For sure. Of our Overwatch trap. Now, if she stands there, she can see both of them. She can also see both of them if she takes full cover. So we'll do that.
Order confirmed. On the move.
Alright, good. And then her spot's going to be... I wonder if both these guys are going to die immediately. I don't think so. So I have to be somewhat cautious. I don't think they're going to run towards me. They'll probably run away. But I'm not sure about that. I can't see either of them from there. Can't see them from there. I can see the Advent soldier from there. So that's better than nothing. I can see both of them from where I am, though. So I think she's just going to stay where she is. We're going to use our new commands here. So I'm going to click on my sniper here. And I'm going to overwatch others.
Affirmative, covering
into Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
On Overwatch.
Oh, they're all women. I didn't realize that. Alright, and now we're going to initiate our shot. And we're going to try to kill the Viper, because I don't know exactly what he's capable of. So, we're just going to try to kill him first. What's our shot on the Advent? We could kill him in one shot, but we're going to try to kill the Viper instead. Because he's probably more dangerous. It's unfortunate that you missed.
Get it together! We're visible here!
Cover's blown. That's a miss. Graze. Alright, we got the Viper down.
Still up! No longer a threat.
Soldier with the stun baton, though, is up and running, though. That's probably going to be bad.
Advent troops spotted!
Uh-oh.
Mech!
Ow! Okay. Definitely not a place I want to stand around. Let's see. Let's see what we can do about stuff here. We have a helpful grenade launcher. That can be used to solve some problems. Like this guy in his cover, for example. So we're gonna start, I think, with that.
Get ready for a surprise.
I just wanna see if I can get rid of his cover early on. Yes, we can. His cover's prone. Alright, good. And he also has one of those fancy stun batons, so we would like him to not be able to use it. And it would be nice if we could occupy this position here that guy is standing in. He is flanked, though, by some of our soldiers. That's a 69% chance. Our sniper has 75 and 69% chance. Our sniper is also the one that can hit for 4 to 6 damage, so it's a good chance if we hit that guy, he dies. Who can you see? You can only see the guy there for 75%. I don't know if I want to be that close to the Viper either, though, on the other hand. So, it might be that I take this shot here on this guy for 75%.
Come on, focus.
Okay, he definitely needs to die. There's no ifs, ands, buts, or babies about that, though.
On the move.
All right, 97% chance with the shotgun. That's looking pretty good. All right.
Target neutralized.
That is a very good thing. All right, now we need to kill the other guy with the with the stun gun. So we'll try to do that. And he gets 5 damage to death.
Hostiles pacified.
Right, and now unfortunately, she's in kind of a dangerous spot, so I think that we will. Can I defend? No, I can't. I can't use a aid. I can use a combat protocol though later on him. I think for the rookie though, we're just going to overwatch her, and if anyone comes in, we should be able to deal. That's a miss. Ooh, whatever that was missed. I don't know what he was attempting to do, but it probably wasn't a good thing. It was very nice of them to destroy their own cover, though, for me. That was helpful. He's probably pissed. Alright. The bad news is that that Advent soldier's behind full cover right now. The good news is that this Viper's in serious trouble. Let's see if we can solve a problem. He's very good at dodging, it seems. Right, her position is starting to become precarious. Because this Advent soldier can walk around for a flank. We don't want that to happen, so I'm going to move this way. And we're probably not going to get to killing that Advent soldier this turn. Alright, that's some nice chain gun damage there. Cannon damage.
Running dry on ammo.
Miss Kelly could drop another guy. Or 6 damage, combat protocol. Send the gremlin to enemy to jolt them, guaranteed damage with increased damage, 100% against the Viper. Combat protocol it is. He's done. Oh, and some goodies. Alright, so we got an Advent soldier up there that's kind of backed against the corner. Now, I believe I can go in, grab the item, and come back out. However, let's see if we can... I know I can also frag grenade that Advent soldier down, and that might be the better option. Also possible is, I believe I can, is he within dash range? I believe I can knife him down, yes. Like, if I wanted to do that, I could slash him for 94% chance of that working. However, if I do that, will I open myself up to a counterattack from a newly discovered pod? The risk of that is pretty high. So, I think I'm just going to walk in.
I'm on it.
Awesome. Illyrium core. Advanced stock. A grenade that even missed shots will do a small amount of damage. That's really nice. Another Illyrium core. So we've been able to upgrade the... get some goodies on the weaponry there. And... that... he's really... alien's really stretched out there. I think it's too risky to, advance on that alien, so I'm just going to tuck back behind the gravestone here. And then if he decides to advance, we have the overwatch ready.
Time to mop him up.
And he falls back. Okay, that works for me. Now we have to remember that he could have also gone into overwatch, so we have to be careful. However, I think it's important that we heal up. So I'm going to take her, drop her back to here.
Heading out.
Move up the rookie.
Rolling.
And I'll move up the sniper to deliver the med pack. So we'll do a med kit heal. Alright. She can reload her gun. She's up front, so she should overwatch. She's kind of in back, so she can reload. We'll kind of do a staggered reload here.
Ready to rock.
Oh, we can... oh, because she hasn't moved, we can reload and overwatch. And again, we're going to reload. I don't know if you could do this in first XCOM. I think reload might have ended the turn. Sniper hasn't reloaded, so we're going to reload again.
Rock and roll.
Very nice. Do we see an even better sniping position? I think we're just going to move the sniper up a little bit.
I'm on it.
And just start to spread out a little bit and get into better positions. We don't see any more enemies, but they're probably over in this corner someplace.
Scanning.
She's going to reload her gun.
It's killing time.
And overwatch.
Heading out.
She can advance. And overwatch.
Overwatch. Closing on target position now.
And the engineer can advance. And overwatch.
I'm on it. I've got movement here.
Alright. Now, she has Shadow Step, so this soldier does not trigger Overwatch fire. So if that enemy is actually overwatching in the front, we'll be able to see him and then snipe him if he's planning the trap. We don't see that, though.
On the move.
Nonetheless, we're going to start moving all of our peoples up, getting them into better positions. Thinking that might be too aggressive, so... And
moving,
we know that there's one guy that's still unaccounted for. Which means we cannot move too aggressively. Or we should not move too aggressively.
I'm on it. Affirmative. Covering now. Got it covered. Overwatch. On overwatch.
Alright, so everyone's overwatching.
Got movement.
Still no action. We'll move up again.
Position.
We don't see anything yet in the little base there. So again, we just move all our guys up.
That's affirmative.
I'll park her there. Yeah, how's the sniper position? I think the sniper can see pretty much all we need to see, so... even the sniper can overwatch.
Got it covered.
And everyone else can overwatch.
I'm on it.
Come get some.
Scanning.
Because we are not pressured for time in the slightest. Alright, got some soldiers coming in. That was expected to miss because of the shotgun.
Shot wide! Admin troops here!
Alright, so they're coming in. Alright, we have... Definitely we're afraid of the guy with the stun. Baton. Now, is anyone not in cover according to the sniper? No. And those are bad shots. So, ideally, we get rid of some of this cover or we get into a flanking position. Now, I think it'd be best to blow up that guy's cover, ideally. But I think I might be out of, grenades. I can go up and slash that guy. But that definitely makes me fodder for the other guys there with the proper weapons. I don't want to be in that position. I can eventually come up to the rooftop here, which could be good. I think it's also possible for me to stand, I believe, inside. Yeah. Inside this little shack here. I think my shots are poor. Well, 49% is not that poor. Let's see if we can take him out down. I'd say that works for me.
Hostile terminated.
Alright. Half cover, I don't think, is works for me right now. I want better than half cover. So I'm going to start pressuring this flank, I think. Now I'm flanking the stun lancer. That's a critical 5 damage. He is in severe hurt, which is good because I believe we can combat protocol him to death. Yes, we can. Question is, who can you see? Not that guy. I need to have a vision of the stun lancer to combat protocol him. But he is flanked, so he is definitely going to make a run for it, is his problem. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to keep everyone in full cover here.
Double time.
Fall back. Just a little bit. Put you into overwatch.
Auto.
And then when the stun lancer runs, it's going to be bye-bye for him. Now, however, they can't... she cannot shoot someone in overwatch, so she might as well take a shot at him. Or she can pistol overwatch. Now, it says I can overwatch with the sniper rifle, but he'll be in squad sight range, so it won't count. The other option is to move forward and pistol overwatch. I could also come to full cover behind this tree here. Now I am in a good position. But we're just going to pistol overwatch in case he decides to charge forward.
Overwatch.
Alright, take a shot against some full cover there. Gonna take a run for it. And gets taken down by the cannon. Excellent. Good job, Azza.
Taken care of.
And we have one more guy with the stun baton. He takes 2 damage. Oh! That was a lot of speed. He moves so fast. Alright. Has the rookie gained her promotion yet? Not, I believe now's the time.
I'm on the move.
Oh, we could carry her. Carry her away. Point blank range with the gun. XCOM rookies,
missed the target.
Yeah.
I'm running low on ammo.
That's what XCOM rookies do. Oh, there's still another guy? There he is. Well, he's there behind full cover. I think it's essential that this guy gets taken out, though.
Moving on target location.
So, we're gonna move right up to him and give him a little bit of close range pepper with the cannon. That was unlucky. Can you remove him? 3 to 5 damage. Yeah, give it a go. Whew! That's...
Got him!
It's good that happened. Alright. and I can't see that guy. He's not going to move because he's in full cover, probably. So he's going to take a shot at one of my soldiers. There's not a whole lot I can do about that. He is the last one out. I'm wondering if my sniper comes up and is annoying with the pistol. A potential option, though. Which is interesting. It is I come from the flank here to deal with him. If he's flanked, he's forced to move, and he may have to take a defensive position.
Lower down.
I will attempt this. Okay, we knew that would happen, but at least he's not in full cover anymore, and we should be able to deal with him just fine. I know, he doesn't like you anymore. You made him move. Alright, so several of my guys can get into position to kill him. We're going to try to make this kill as guaranteed as we can do it. I think, do I come in with the flanking kill again or with the cannon? I can do that. Or I can let the rookie have another kill. Or I can shoot him with the sniper. Sniper's got a few kills this mission already. The engineer, though, has got some kills this mission, too. We've been spreading it around. From here is a shot on him. So we're just gonna have her march forward. That's 71% chance. That looks good enough to me.
Target disabled.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed.
Kelly's just taking a little nap there. Supply raid completed. Turns taken 11. Lots of enemies killed. A couple soldiers wounded. That's not so bad. Is my injured soldier... Oh, they just have her sitting up there. That's nice. We must have revived her. Move furthest. Dealt most damage. Ozymemesis. Not bad. Everyone seems pretty proud of that mission. As well they should. Engineer is a credit to team. And we got some loot off of that Viper, too, which was really good. So that all so even misses will do some damage. However, we got troops that took big hits. Fortunately, the which class was the rookie assigned? Let's see. So we got another specialist. It's all right. Memzis. We're going to give her shredder too, so she can shred some armor. She does not need extra padding. Whoops, and I didn't select all the things. That's alright. So we got Lyrium Core and the Advanced Stock. Missed shots still deal 2 damage to the target. That's huge. Okay, someone's gun's gonna get that. Viper Corpse. Viper's powerful tail muscles continue to clench reflexively hours after death. The precautionary brain imaging shows no trace of higher order function. We got some stun lancer corpses and some alien alloys now. Awesome. Light, flexible, incredibly strong in the fabrication of their weapons and armor. I like how the alloys like seem to have like veins in them. That looks so cool. Illyrium crystals. These crystals are incredibly valuable as a power source for a wide variety of applications, but may take a significant amount of research to unlock their potential. And 112 supplies. That was a huge haul. Viper autopsy. This creature is clearly reptilian in nature, although it appears to not only sentient, but highly intelligent. Still, underlying physiology is remarkably similar to a number of terrestrial species, including the venom sacs, which you might be able to synthesize and incorporate for our medical supplies. Advanced Medkit Project. She got reduced will because she got all like shot at and almost dead. Alright, so we now build a facility. And we're going to build a workshop so we can get additional gremlin drones out and about. It's going to take 20 days to build that.
Initiated.
But once we have that out, then we're going to be in a lot better shape. Intact structures. Commander, after a recent success, members of the resistance in New India have brought us reports of activity we might want to investigate. So, if I investigate it, I get rookies. I think that's a not now type of thing. Let's see, how's our soldier list doing? We're starting to get our soldiers backed up enough. Alright, so we've already gone with combat protocol. Haywire protocol. You may target robotic and mechanical enemies with gremlin, attempting to hack them and seize control. Or revival protocol. Send the gremlin to an ally to remove any negative mental status. Disoriented, stunned, panicked, or unconscious. That also seems really good. But this seems to be our combat engineer. So we're going to keep on with the combat hacker, not mix too much, and go with Haywire Protocol, because I have a sense that that's going to be cool to be able to mind control aliens. Warhorse. Right. So. Last time when we were looking at, we're still making contact with New Arctic. Yeah, we continue doing that.
Setting course for the Arctic territories.
Because I want the black market too. Alien debris cleared. Alright, so another room's cleared out, and we got some more supplies. And we can add an engineer to decrease the construction time, so we will. Alright, and then once we get the gremlins, we can use the gremlins to clear more rooms. Alright, New Arctic. Has been contacted. Hello, Arctic people. We're totally XCOM. And we totally won't eat your brains. Virgio Confidello, Commander. The peoples of the Arctic stand ready to help XCOM however we can.
New regional contacts located.
Alright, and I can talk to Western United States. although I'm maxed out currently.
Setting course for East Asia.
No, I didn't mean to do that. We don't need to gain any more intel. Yeah, tightly. I don't think so, anyway.
Alright. New course.
Perhaps we'll go research stuff to see so we can open up a black market. See what it is. Uh-oh. Alright, another ding from the Avatar Project.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar Project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
Alright. Hey, Ray.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
Woo!
These magnetic-based weapons are a lot like the early railgun prototypes.
Yes.
They fire projectiles at extremely high velocity.
Woo! I like it. Alright. Magnetic weapons, codename Orsted. Having finally gotten a closer look at the Gauss rifle technology Advent has deployed among their forces, I'm fairly confident we can develop a magnetic weapon system of comparable power. The obvious question, why not simply use Advent weapons directly, was discovered early on by a resistance force in the field. Some years ago, the aliens began integrating a sort of genetic verification technology into their weapons that prevents them from functioning by any species whose DNA has not been pre-encoded. Unfortunately, the system also exerts lethal force on an unsuspecting authorized user, a fact we should disseminate as widely as possible among the resistance cells we have in contact with. As for our own variation in the technology, Dr. Shen and I have taken components of the alien weaponry recovered from the field and utilized the key elements to develop a suitable prototype. We can safely begin reproducing the system as the needed materials become available. So, mag pistol? Shard gun, which is the shotgun. Magnetic rifle. And Advent Stun Lancer Autopsy. Given our extensive battlefield experience against the Advent Stun Lancer, the Advent Stun Lancer Autopsy can now be completed instantaneously. Well, let's do that then.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city center. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units. Although Advent clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers, it seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Aha. On both the physical and genetic level, the Advent Stun Lancers are nearly identical to the troopers our forces regularly see in combat. However, a minor yet crucial adjustment to the muscle fiber density of the Lancer improves both agility and overall survivability. Equipped with non-lethal weapons capable of easily disabling human targets, these Lancers were first deployed during the earliest days following Advent's establishment of city centers, when civil unrest was more a common problem than outright resistance. In studying their usage and deployment, it raised an interesting question. If the Lancers were among the first Advent forces deployed, and their survivability is somewhat higher than the standard trooper, did the aliens consciously reduce the trooper's strength based on their assessment of human combat readiness? This would imply a system of rapid genetic modification beyond which I previously imagined the aliens were capable of. It also just demonstrated a degree of genetic frugality that I would have assumed was irrelevant to the aliens, based on the variety of unusual experiments they've conducted. That's interesting. They cheapen out. Arc Blade. Where pure kinetic energy is no longer sufficient on the field, the Arc Blade may prove necessary. Boosts the standard sword combat effectiveness with addition of an electric field capable of stunning enemies that are not killed outright. Woo! Looks like we got some things to build. Okay, and I need more resistant resistance radios to contact more areas, so I will have to do that for increased money. I mean, yes, I need increased supplies.
I'd assume you'd make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Sweet. Engineering.
Maybe we should start training someone else to pilot the Avenger. I'm never going to get any work done if Mr. Bradford can't keep the ship steady.
Hello, Commander.
Hates Bradford's flying. Oh, and I can build Wheatley too. Let's look at weapons here. Whew. Oh, but they're all squad updates. That's very cool. Nonetheless, I think I'm gonna have to hold off on those weapon upgrades till I get some more money.
Made headway interfacing our equipment with the alien technology still embedded throughout the ship. Most of the primary systems are now operating on some combination of our technology and theirs. My hope is to use the best of both worlds to come up with something new, something the aliens won't expect.
Aha.
Maybe once this is all over, we should take this ship and go colonize one of their planets.
Bow chicka. Okay, Oh, I can assign uniforms too. When they become standardized. I'll do that off screen. That's kind of cool though. How much do I have for like rookies and soldiers? I can recruit rookies as I need them though for missions. And I might just be given rookies, so. And they don't seem to be dying very much for me, so.
Priority message coming.
That's all right.
Commander. Putting it on screen now. I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership, Commander, and you have outdone yourself.
Well, thank you. Okay, new staff available. Recruit new staff at Resistance Headquarters. Alright, dark events. Received intel regarding the aliens' current activities. Preparations to foil these dark events before they can be enacted are already underway. Counter operations will be available soon. Here's the alloy plating. Minor breakthrough. Alien scientists make great strides on the Avatar project. Instantly add one block to the progress meter. And then there's a hidden event, which I can reveal for 20 intel. I don't like sitting around my base trying to generate intel. And intel is kind of important. But then having a mission to foil something possibly very nasty could be good. The aliens hide an ambush among the populace, pacing hidden faceless aliens on each mission for a month. Oh. So that was probably good. They're definitely difficult. Commander, the Resistance has provided a location with hidden resource cache. Once we travel the area, we can collect supplies for further efforts, and that's a lot of supplies. For now, we'll just ignore it. It only takes 3 days to gain that many supplies. Uh-oh.
Commander, we've received word that the aliens have completed a facility devoted to their work on the Avatar project. If we can establish contact with the local resistance forces in this region, we can make a move on that facility and destroy it to set back the aliens' operation.
Okay. But it is very far away. Okay. We're gonna have to start picking away at the Avatar project. We'll finish off the black market here, see what it gets us.
The market is open.
Okay, what can I buy? Rush Research Plated Armor, Rush Research Psychonics, Rush Research Viper Autopsy. But it takes a lot of intel to do it. Okay, I'll keep these kind of things in mind. Cell inventory, what do I get for this stuff? Not a whole lot. I don't know if that was that great of a investment there.
Avenger plotting new course.
Okay, well, so we'll get some more supplies. Oh, communications has new high priority mission information. Objective, neutralize target. Reward, 167 supplies and 80 intel. Well, we'll definitely launch the mission on that.
14, East Asia.
Alright, the big squad's out. We got Corporal Turtle. Squaddy Peterson. Sergeant Halvorsen. Wait, look at all these grenades. So many grenade launchers. Okay, we don't need quite this many grenade launchers. I think we need a ranger would be good here. We'll bring Potato Salad along. Corporal Salad. Okay. Anything else we want to do? She's getting a weapon upgrade. And so it's going to be the advanced stock. Miss shots still deal 2 damage to the target, so she'll be able to, like, if I can't finish someone off, the sniper will at least be able then to maybe finish off the last bits of damage to it. Let's see, where's the stock? What's the stock look like? Yes, it might not be the best weapon to apply it to, because eventually we'll be doing the better weapons, but we're going to make utility items available, weapons available, armor available, and Salad is going to have the nanoscale vest, and still the shotgun. I still think that's okay that she's a close combat specialist. Still has the smoke grenade. Smoke grenade is redundant with her protocol that she uses on the aid protocol. So it makes more sense for her to have the flashbang grenade. And the other to have the smoke grenade. So we're going to do that. Loadout. Flashbang's getting replaced with smoke grenade on our grenade launcher person. And on our engineer, she's going to be getting the... Or she could just stick with frag. I will give her the flashbang grenade for a little bit even more utility. Corporal Turtle. I don't mind having all these grenades in. It really makes it a lot easier to set up kills when nobody has any armor. However, that being said, just having this many grenades is fine. Sometimes I just don't want to get that close with my Rangers. Apparently this is an easy mission too. I should maybe consider taking in a rookie. We're gonna remove this soldier. And we'll take in one rookie. We'll leave. We'll recruit one rookie. Look at this, all the extra soldiers we got. Yes, this guy with the piece of wheat in his mouth. I like that. He says, I just don't care. He has personality, even for a rookie. I want to carry on with the mission. So we'll still keep in with the... And we'll add our rookie in. Customize. No, he's his hair bun is a little unique. It's okay. Accept all kinds in XCOM. This looks like a good squad of death. Let's launch this mission. I'm feeling it. Feeling the power. Operation Enduring Dirge. That's not an optimistic mission title.
Asking for our help in dealing with a VIP said to be working in close collaboration with Advent forces in this region. It's likely the aliens will be providing security. We need to secure the AO and eliminate any hostile contacts nearby. Capture the VIP if possible. If not, take him down.
How do we capture him? Like, I don't think we have the gear to capture him. Like, what, if we kill all the aliens, does he, like, is he captured? Is he rendered unconscious?